Bikes, we got probably, what, nine miles to go?
It's raining out, and all me and Pete, we brought with the t-shirts on our back.
We got 9 miles to go with the bike here. You'll probably see it's raining pretty good.
What'd you have for lunch?
I had my dairy shake powder, some Skittles, and a piece of beef jerky.
So, here we are on the trail. Actually, you can probably hear the weather's not turning out to be the 102 degrees the weatherman thought it was going to be. We got a little thunder and lightning storm up above us.
We've probably come about 15 miles already today. We're at the Great Rock Wall. Jake and I have just named it. And we're going to try to make it at least to the river crossing tonight.
Taking time, relaxing, but we both feel good. Breaking camp, and now we're gonna make the ascent to Gamma Peak today.
This is where we branch off. We're on the Pacific Crest Trail, and as we take a right turn here, we're gonna head up to Gamma Ridge.
Well, when you get up here on top, you can see our trail here. This is what it looks like all the way until we hit the Alpine. Hasn't been maintained in a long time. And about every 10 feet. You got logs all the way down it. It's about a quarter to five. It's kind of a thunder, lightning, storm rolled in, and we didn't figure it in our best interest to be out on the ridge line. We got grouse hooting all sides of us. It's becoming a little bit torturous as we have no efficient means of killing them.
Well, this is Gamma Peak behind us here. That's what we're going to climb right now. It's 6 o'clock, oh, it's 7 o'clock actually, in the evening. And this is day 2 of our hike. We're about 30 miles in. Glacier Peak is over here on the left. And there's a group of nannies and kids. Probably what I assume are some nannies and kids over here.
Comes Dave, summiting Gamma Peak.
Pretty awesome, man. Something we haven't been able to do. We tried in 2006, but we were unsuccessful.
Yeah.
So Jake miraculously spotted a salt and pepper shaker or something down in there.
Film canister.
Oh, okay. So, which we believe to be the registry for people making it to the top of Gamma Peak. So we're gonna check it out. See when was the last time. It'll be cool just to see when was the last time somebody signed it.
Mannheim Bowringer.
Oh, there's a pencil right in there, Barker. It's even sharpened.
Here we go, Jack Merrigan from Olympia, Washington, and Dan LaFoe. We're here in September 2000. Yesterday we did the Gamma Peak. Today we found some new energy. We're gonna go try and find the hot springs.
Down into Gamma Creek here. We're approximately 0.3 miles away from the hot springs according to the GPS. So we're gonna walk down the creek and try to find it. The cool thing is the last little bit, probably about the last 400 feet that we dropped in here, was fairly easy. The first probably 200 feet or so was gnarly, and actually I wanted to call it quits a couple times. I wiped out pretty good. There were some pretty good gravel chutes and slide areas that were tough for walking on. But now we're down here. We're probably as close as anyone's been in a while, and certainly as close as we've ever been.
Well, here we are at the end of our trail. Just beyond these trees, our goat path leads to a typical goat ending, a big craggy knob that you can't really get down. Hard to see from here, but about maybe 200-300 yards below us is the creek again. Kind of flattens out, and that's right about where the GPS points say the hot springs are. Look below us here, we found some stuff in the bushes, some other crushed hopes and dreams of other hikers that have followed the same goat trail, only to find that it leads to nowhere.